Hello, I'm Christina from Milan Creative Co, and in this tutorial I want to show you how to make a seamless pattern wreath in Illustrator. I'm going to use a few doodles that I scanned and vectorized in Illustrator to make a hand-drawn wreath. First, I want to show you how to make a simple hand-drawn wreath from a single illustration, so I am going to use this one. Now, when you make pattern wreaths, it's important to have a horizontal illustration. Mine is vertical, so I'm going to right-click on it, go to Transform, Rotate, and let's set minus 90 degrees. That's perfect, so press OK to rotate it. Now open the Brushes panel by going to Window Brushes or by pressing F5. And go to the bottom of the Brushes panel and click on New Brush. Then select Pattern Brush from the menu and press OK. You can see here how the pattern brush will look. Now we won't need a corner because our brush will be circular, so I am going to select none. And also make sure the side tile is set to original. If you want, you can change the colorization method to Hue Shift. If you leave none, your pattern brush will be black or the color of your illustration, and then press OK. You can find your new brush in the Brushes panel. So let's test it. I am going to change the stroke to black and the fill to none. Then I am going to select the ellipse tool. You can press L on your keyboard and while holding down the Shift key, create a circle. Then go to the Brushes panel and click on your new brush. This is your simple hand-drawn floral wreath. If you want to change the color, make sure your wreath is selected and then just choose another color. Of course, if you don't have Hue Shift selected, if your colorization method is set to none, for example, the color will not change. If you're wondering why there's a small gap between the illustrations, it's because the pattern brush tool will unite the highest point from an illustration with the lowest point from the next. But it won't distort and merge the illustrations, so you won't have a circle with leaves and flowers outside of it. Next, I want to show you how to make a more complex pattern brush. So I'm going to use these two illustrations and let's also use the reflect tool, so go to transform, reflect, and vertically reflect them, then press copy. So we have four small illustrations that we are going to use to create a seamless pattern wreath. So let's arrange them. I want this wreath to have more than one color, so I am going to change the fill color of each element. Now let's select all of them and group them. Now I am going to hold down the Alt key, you can see the double arrows, and then I'm going to click and drag to make a copy. I'm also holding down the Shift key. You can see here where they intersect. So I am also going to add a few small dots just to fill in the gaps between them. So let's select this yellow and I am going to use the blob brush tool for this. You don't actually need to make a copy of your illustration, but it will help you fill in all the gaps or rearrange the illustration if it's needed. So let's select both of them and group them by pressing Ctrl G. And now I am also going to rotate this one. So go to Transform, Rotate 90 degrees, and I'm going to make a copy because I also want to show you what happens if you use a vertical illustration. So let's select our horizontal illustration, go to the Brushes panel and click on New Brush. Just like before, select Pattern Brush and press OK. Give your pattern brush a new name if you want. I am going to set the corner tile to none. This step is actually optional. Make sure the side tile is set to original. Also make sure fit is set to stretch to fit. And I am going to leave the colorization method to none for now. Then press OK to create a new brush. The new brush is now in the Brushes panel, so we are going to test it. So I am going to select the ellipse tool and create another circle. Then I'm going to click on my new brush. It actually looks great. I might need to change the colors maybe or move the dots a little, but I'm just going to leave it like this for now. So let's go back and see what happens if you try to make a pattern brush from this illustration. So let's select it and drag it to the brushes panel. I'm going to select pattern brush again, press OK, then remove the corner tile. Everything else looks great, so I'm just going to press OK to create the brush. So let's use this circle. I'm going to click on it and select the new brush. This actually is quite an interesting effect, and I think it's great for making mandalas, but it's not what we're looking for. So I'm going to select the other brush. And I also want to show you how to recolor this brush. Select your floral wreath, then go to the brushes panel and double click on the brush. It will open the pattern brush options. Then change the colorization method from none to tints. Press OK to save it. Click apply to stroke. And as you can see, maybe this yellow is not the best color. Let's try a darker one. You can see that it recolors all the element with a tint of the color you've selected. So you are going to have lighter colors. I'm going to go back to the brushes panel and double click on it again, select tints and shades, then press OK. Apply to strokes. And as you can see now, you have tints and shades of this green. So you have lighter and darker colors. I actually really like this colorization method. And it works well with lighter color as well as darker colors. So let's go back again, and this time I am going to use hue shift, then press OK. Click on apply to strokes. You can see it will create a color palette based on the color you select. You can actually get really interesting color palette with this colorization method. Hope you've enjoyed this tutorial. If you want to see more Photoshop and Illustrator tutorials, please like this video and subscribe to my channel. Thanks for watching!